Okay, so today we are going to see about JavaScript, and then in this JavaScript we will learn introduction to JavaScript, and we will see the difference between Java and JavaScript. Then we will see how to create a variable in JavaScript, then how to print something in JavaScript with the help of document.write line, then how to create a pop-up message using alert. And then how will you get the value with the help of window.prompt? Then how to create a functions in JavaScript, like that we are going to do. Then we'll see about some event handling. Then we'll see some data validation using JavaScript. In that data validation, we will go for something called regular expression. And then we'll discuss about the difference between JS, jQuery and AngularJS, like that, and like that we'll go. Okay, so first JavaScript is a client-side programming language. So JavaScript is a client-side programming language, or we can call it as a client-side scripting language, which help us to validate the data. For example, you are creating, in the last class we have seen about HTML. With the help of HTML, we can create web pages where, for example, we can use forms to get the content from user, to get the data from user. To validate the data, we can go for this JavaScript. For example, let us consider one example. When you perform any sign up operation, you are asked to enter the password as well as the confirm password. So the password and confirm password must be same. So to validate that, we can go for JavaScript. Or consider another case, you want to set the password with a minimum of 8 characters, and it should have a lowercase and it should have uppercase, it should have numbers like that. So for that kind of validation, we can go for this JavaScript. So JavaScript is nothing but it's a client side scripting language, where it is mainly used for data validation. And using JavaScript is an older way. So some nowadays they are using something called AngularJS. So AngularJS is an advanced version of jQuery, and where jQuery is an advanced version of JavaScript. So in JavaScript, you have to write many validation manually, but in jQuery, there will be plenty of predefined data validations are there. If we use that, we can effectively write a program without any bug, and we can effectively validate the data without any bug like that. Then AngularJS is also there. It's an advanced version of jQuery. So now programmers, they are using either jQuery or AngularJS. They are just ignoring this JavaScript, because everything we have to write and we have to maintain like that. So this is all about the introduction to JavaScript, and we will see what is the difference between Java and JavaScript. Like I said, JavaScript is a client-side scripting language, where Java is a programming language. We know the difference between programming language as well as the scripting language. So scripting language is used to for it has some functionalities where we can use it, but it can't have full version similar to Java. So JavaScript is said to be a loosely coupled programming language. So it is said to be a loosely coupled programming language, and Java is said to be tightly coupled programming language, where we can use the concept of inheritance, polymorphism, and so many things where we can use, and we can use all the OOPs concept in Java. Whereas in JavaScript, we can't able to use all the concepts, but we can use some limited functionalities, and we can write our code. So Java is a programming language, and JavaScript is a scripting language. So this is the difference between Java and JavaScript. So to execute and to run the JavaScript, we have to use something called JDK. But for executing the JavaScript, no need to install any compiler or anything, because the browser itself will interpret this JavaScript and it executes. So that is the second difference between Java and JavaScript. So I will just tell you again, like in Java, Java is said to be a tightly coupled programming language and JavaScript is a loosely coupled programming language. And in Java, like we have to compile and execute, we have to use something called JDK, that is Java Developers Kit. And we have to use the command like Java C for compilation and Java for execution. But in JavaScript, it's like we can type the code and the browser itself will execute this kind of JavaScript code, because we will embed this JavaScript code inside HTML, and with that we will execute this JavaScript in the browser itself. Okay, so now we will see a basic JavaScript program, and we will see how to write a basic JavaScript program and how to execute that we will see. So similar to HTML, so what we have to do is we have to create a HTML program. For example, I'm going to create an HTML program. So I will have HTML/HTML. Then I will have a head section. Then I have like end of head section. Then I have a body section. Then I have a slash body section. Okay. So now what I can do is I can write some HTML code here. For example, HTML body code like that. And if I want to include the JavaScript inside HTML, what I can do is we can put JavaScript anywhere in the program, but normally they will put that in head section. So in the head section, what we can do is since JavaScript is a scripting language, we have to use something called script tag. And we have to set the type as script type equal to text/JavaScript. Or simply, if you put a script also, it will work. But this is the correct format. So to include JavaScript in HTML, we have to use this line. So script type equal to text/JavaScript, and we have to close the script. Okay. So now to print something in JavaScript, what we have to do is, in Java, we have to use system.out.println. But in JavaScript, we have to use something called document.writeln, which will print the data with help of JavaScript, like welcome to JavaScript. So this document.writeln will print, which help us to print something in HTML. So I will save this as some name index.html like that. So okay, sorry, I have saved it here. So we have embedded JavaScript inside HTML. So we can directly execute this index.html like this. You see this HTML body code is executed because we have created HTML body code that with H1 we have printed. And this welcome to JavaScript will print because we have used something called document.writeln. So we know that, like, from this we will understand that document.writeln is used to print something in JavaScript. So the output will be like this. So first the JavaScript will print the content as welcome to JavaScript, followed by H1, like the HTML H1 code. So it will get printed. So from this example, we can understand that Java is, to print something in JavaScript, we can use something called document.writeln. So that is the thing about document.writeln. And now what we can do is we can include a HTML tag inside JavaScript also. For example, if I want to make like this one to be bold, what I can do is I can just add a bold tag inside this document.writeln. And if I save it and if I execute this, I'm saving this. not getting the result. Actually, it should. We can embed. We can embed the HTML code inside document.writeln itself. But I don't know why it is not working. Maybe I will just check and I will let you know. So we can also embed this HTML tag inside JavaScript like this. But currently, I don't know why it's not working. Maybe I will just check with that. Okay. So next, we will see how to declare a variable in JavaScript. Since JavaScript is a loosely coupled programming language, so there is no need. There is no data type for JavaScript like integer or string or anything like that. So what we can do is we can simply simply there is a variable called var, where we can use this where we can use this JavaScript variable name like that. For example, var name equal to xyz like that, where when you assign the value to this name, say xyz, it is considered to be string, and this var will be considered to be a string. Suppose if you store that if you store any integer value, the var will be considered to be an integer. Or if you store some decimal value, it will consider as double like that. So there is no data type for Java. It will simply takes the data type of the value which is assigned. So if I want to print something, I can simply use document.writeln. And I can print the name is, so directly I can use similar to Java, I can use plus for the concatenation. I can print the name, I can save it. If I refresh, why it's not getting loaded? Wait, I think I am storing this, I need to store this inside JavaScript. Okay. Yeah, I think now this bold as well as this thing will work actually. Now you see that bold is there. So let me just save, check the code. Okay. So in document.writeln, so I missed this line. So document.writeln. So now this both the code will be get executed. You see. Yeah. So you can see the bold gets executed, then we print that the name is XYZ, then followed by HTML code like that. So this is how we will use this JavaScript. So to declare any variable in JavaScript, you can simply use something called var, followed by variable name and value. So here the value is assigned to be string. So this var is said to be a string variable. And internally, the JavaScript will understand whether the variable is string or integer or double or float, anything like that. So this is how we can create a variable. And this is how the JavaScript will understand the variable type by itself. So this is the reason we are calling that JavaScript as a loosely coupled programming language like that. So any doubt up to this? Any doubt up to this? Okay. So can you all hear me now? Some of them they are putting like they can't able to hear me like that. If you can't able to hear me, maybe like you can just disconnect the meeting, then you can reconnect it, then you can hear. Okay. So now what we have seen is like we have seen like introduction to JavaScript, then we have seen the difference between Java and JavaScript. Then we have seen variables in JavaScript, where we can, for every variable, we have to use something called var. Suppose if you don't want to use var, you can simply assign a variable equal to value itself. So JavaScript will understand your variable and it will print the corresponding thing for you. So like this. So it is not mandatory to put a var here. So if you omit it, it is also not a problem. Like JavaScript will automatically take that for you. Okay. So now what we can do is we can go for the next topic, that is alert. So alert is nothing but to create, it is used to create a pop-up message. So pop-up message is like when you just see this code, you will understand. For example, I am assigning the name value as XYZ. And if I want to create a pop-up message that prints the name, I can simply use something called alert. So what it will do is it will create a pop-up message and it will print the name is followed by XYZ like that. So if I refresh, you can see that the alert message is first executed, that the name is XYZ like that. Then when you select OK, you will get the other contents like welcome to JavaScript and HTML body code. Like that. So normally you might see in this alert message, suppose if you enter a wrong data, for example, if it asks to enter the phone number of you, suppose if you give some string instead of a phone number, it will show you like the phone number is invalid like that. So this kind of stuffs can be implemented with the help of alert kind of thing. And similarly, you also might seen about whenever you submit the form, you'll get the alert messages. The form is submitted like that. You can do like that with the help of this alert. So alert message is used to create a pop-up message, and in JavaScript we can create a pop-up message with the help of this alert. And this alert is similar to a message box in Visual Basic maybe. And what happened is like instead of JavaScript, sometimes like in olden days they use something called VBScript also, and VBScript is specially made for Internet Explorer kind of application. But currently they are using this JavaScript in all the platform because of its platform independence, and they are doing like that. And so since the release of jQuery and AngularJS, it can be platform independent and it can be used anywhere or in any programming languages they are using that. So this is all about alert. Now we will see something which is very interesting called window.prompt. So window.prompt will help us to get the content from user or to get the value from the user. For example, here the name equal to XYZ, where the value is assigned to this variable directly in the program. But if I want to get the content from the user, I can use something called window.prompt like this. So window.prompt followed by, you can give enter your name like that. And if there is no name is entered, it will just take the default value as no name like that. So now I can save this. So I can refresh. So first it will ask you to enter your name. So I can just give my name like that. So the name is printed in pop-up message, and you'll get the other messages like welcome to JavaScript and HTML body code. Okay. So any doubt in this window.prompt or alert or document.writeline, you have any doubt in it? Any doubt, guys? Okay, so I will just explain this again. So to create a JavaScript, we have to use this script type equal to text slash JavaScript and script slash script to end the script. And we can place the script anywhere in the program. Like we can place it inside body. Also it will work. So I have placed this code in body. So now it will work. Suppose if I don't give any value, like by default it takes no name and it prints the no name and it prints the other thing like welcome to JavaScript and a body to HTML like that. So like what we can do is, but we can include JavaScript anywhere in the program, but the best way to include is like we can include in head section of the JavaScript. Okay, so then to print something in JavaScript, we have to use something called document.writeln, and we can also include tags inside document.writeln. And to get the content from the user, we can use window.prompt followed by enter your name, or maybe so this enter your name is a information, and the second value is like if no name is given, it will take this no name as a input, and it is a, it will assign to name. Then alert is used for a pop-up message that help us to display any information through pop-ups. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a program to print like the age, like for example the program will ask for the age, and if the age is from 0 to 5 it should print child, or from if it is from 6 to 10 it should display like some value, like then if it display from 11 to 19 it will tell like teenage, then after that it will print adult, like that it should do. So for that we have to perform some mathematical function. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to print this with the help of this JavaScript. So I will just write some code in HTML first. So refresh the page to execute JS again, like that. So I will tell you why I just put a refresh the page to execute JS again when we execute the code. Now what I am going to do is I am going to create a variable called age using window.prompt. So I am going to get the value like enter your age. So by default it will take 0 as the input if you don't give any value. This var age is a variable like window.prompt enter your age, like that. By default when you get anything through window.prompt it is of type string. So we have to convert that into an integer. In JavaScript we will use something called integer.parseInt. In Java it is like we have to use parseInt alone. So let me just check. So a is for age. So I will just parseInt this age so that this age which we got through string will be converted to a variable a which is of integer, and we can do that with the help of this parseInt, like that. Then we can apply the normal syntax, like if a is less than or equal to 5, so you can print through like alert infant, like that. Then if a is greater than 5 and a is less than 11, so we can call it as small ones, like that. Then if or you can use else if also, else if, else if a greater than or equal to 11 and a less than or equal to 19, So it will print alert PNH. Else it will print adult like that. So now I will save this. I will just refresh the page. So it will ask you to enter the age. For example, if I enter the age 5, so it will display infant. So now it will show you like refresh the page to execute this JS again. So each and every time if you want to execute the JavaScript, it will we have to use something called refresh. So refresh again, I am just giving some content as 15. So it will print teenage. Then I have to refresh for the next input. Then if I give 25, it will print adult like that. So to execute the JavaScript again, the page must be refreshed. And this is like if you want to like without refreshing the page, we have to use something called Ajax like kind of thing. And but for the basic Java Java code, we have to refresh the browser so that it will execute the JavaScript again and again. Okay, so you have any doubt in this basic code, maybe we can go for some questions, then we can continue with the topic. Do you have any doubt in this?